Hi guys. Hello guys. Now we are in the Museum of Formulation Proclamation Manuscript, and now we're going to describe all about this building. History of the Proclamation Document Museum and Building. This building was founded around 1920 with a European architecture Art Deco, with a land area of 3,914 square meters and a building area of 1,138. In 1931, the owner was on behalf of PT Asuransi Jiwasraya when the Pacific War broke out. This building was used by the British Consul General until Japan occupied Indonesia.
During the Japanese occupation, this building was the residence of Rear Admiral Tadashi Maeda, head of the liaison official between the Navy and the Army. After Indonesian independence on August 17, 1945, this building remained the residence of Rear Admiral Tadashi Maeda until the Allies land in Indonesia, September 1945. After the Japanese defeat, this building became the headquarters of the British Army. The transfer of ownership of this building took place in the nationalization of foreign nationals in Indonesia. This building was handed over to the Ministry of Finance and its management by the Jiwasraya Insurance Company.
In 1961, this building was contracted by the British Embassy until 1981. Furthermore, this building was received by the Ministry of Education and Culture on December 28, 1981. In 1922, this building was used by the National Library as an office. This building is very important for the Indonesian people because on August 16 until 17, 1945, this historical event took place, namely the formulation of the Indonesian Nation Proclamation Text. Therefore, in 1984, the Minister of Education and Culture, Prof. Nugroho Noto Susanto, instructed by the Directorate of Museum to realize this historic building into the Museum of Formulation of the Proclamation Manuscript.
Based on the decree of the Minister of the Education and Culture number 476 and 1992 that 24 November 1992 the building located at Imam Bonjol Street number 1 is designed as the museum for the formulation of the proclamation text, which is the technical implementation unit in the field of culture under the Directorate General of Culture, the Ministry of Education and Culture.
Guys, now we're gonna get into the museum, so let's follow us. So guys, this is the first room of the museum, and this is the room that Sukarno met the Maeda.
In August 16, 1945, after the long trip from Rangas Dengklok, Bung Karno, Bung Hatta, and Ahmad Subarjo arrived on the house of Rear Ahmad Tadashi Maeda at 10 p.m. After a warm greeting from the young admiral, the guest then explain about the intention to organize a meeting in preparation for the independence of Indonesia.
Maeda then explained that they had a report to the Gunseikan Japanese military government first before organizing the lunch meeting. At the Gunseikan office, they met with a Major General Nashimura Otoshi, which then explained that Japan could not be a part of Indonesia independence because maintaining status quo of Indonesia was a part of them. Then the Japanese surrender to the Allied force, and the general also forbade the forthcoming meeting. Back at Maeda House at 2:30 a.m. Still disappointed because the general response, they decided to proclaim Indonesia independence right away. Maeda then said that he didn't want to interfere and went to his room upstairs.
So, let's move on to the next room.
At 3 a.m. Augustus 17, 1945, Bung Karno, Bung Hatta, and Ahmad Subarjo sat at long dinner table and started making the proclamation text. Bung Karno wrote the draft, the other conveyed their ideas verbally.
After the text and the proclamation, they agreed to put in the word. We, the people of Indonesia, hereby declare the independence of Indonesia. Bung Hatta added the second sentence, a statement regarding the transfer of power. At last, the proclamation concept was finalized with some scribing marking the ideas exchanged between the conceptors. Soekarno, Hatta, and Subarjo then head to the main hall where everyone's waiting.
After the audience agreed with the concept drafted by Bung Karno, Bung Hatta, and Ahmad Subarjo, Bung Karno ordered Saito Melik to type the proclamation manuscript. Accompanied by Bam Diah, he typed in the room right by the kitchen. Saito Melik changed three words, tempoh to tempo, the representative of Indonesia, to in the name of the people of Indonesia. He also changed the date format of the text. After he is done with the typing, the text was signed by Bung Karno and Bung Hatta on the piano by the stairs.
So guys, this is the fourth room of this museum and this is the approval of the proclamation. And carefully and repeatedly, Bung Karno read the text to the audience, and then he asked the audience whether they agree or not with the text Bung Karno recalled, and the audience delivered an enthusiastic and thunderous agreement. Then Bung Karno repeat the questions, brothers, do you really agree? And they delivered the same thunderous yes. Then rose disagreement over who should sign the manuscript. Finally, Soekarno moved forward and said loudly, not everyone of us should sign the manuscript. Only two people at the same time that can sign the script. And the people is Soekarno and Hatta. The suggestion was accepted by the audience with applause. Then Bung Karno ordered Saito Melik to type the manuscript.
So, this museum has second floor, and let me see the second floor. about this museum, and thank you for watching. Bye guys.
Bye.